tell you a little bit about myself to start with. And I graduated in 1963, so I've been in practice treating people for over 50 years. And I've been treating people without any form of medication, whether it be homeopathic, whether it be whatever form you like to think of. I teach people how to live so that they don't need any form of medication. In actual fact, I would say to you quite conclusively that if you can survive with medication, you can survive much better without it. In actual fact, if you realize, firstly, that all medication is poison. So how can that poison not be poisoning you? It's certainly not helping. It's not removing the cause. It is treating the effect. And this is the same with vaccination. Vaccination, as you saw there, is a medication. And it is poisonous to us. So if it is so good, if it is actually benefiting those who are using it, why then do they fear those who are unvaccinated? I say to you that today we are faced with medical and pharmaceutical dictatorship. What happened last time we had a dictatorship in the world? We had a world war from 1939 to 1945. Well, now we have another world war, vaccination. And we need to be able to stand up to this. You want to know how bad it is? Well, I have 5 books in publication. I am a member of the Australian Osteopathic Association, or Osteopathic Association of Australia, as it's now known. I'm also a lifestyle consultant. I was recently informed that I could no longer be permitted to address the conference of the Osteopathic Association. I was no longer allowed to display and sell my books at the conference. Isn't this a further aspect of that dictatorship? And I can say to you quite confidently that if you really, really want to feel safe, if you want to get over the fear that is engendered in us by the medical profession, by pharmaceutical companies, by our governments, in actual fact, then you can do so by changing your lifestyle. Do you know that more people die every year from the fear of the bites of non-venomous snakes than die from the bites of venomous snakes? It's fear, isn't it? This is what we're told. If you don't do this, then you're going to die. I can tell you, I used to be an asthmatic. And what do they tell you when you're an asthmatic? If you don't take the medication, you're going to die. I haven't had an asthmatic attack for over 50 years, and I haven't taken medication for over 50 years. I can stand here and tell you all sorts of stories like this. I have had under my care practically people experiencing and suffering from practically every known medical condition, from 6 weeks of age until over 80 years of age. All of those people have experienced benefit. All have got better than they were. In actual fact, I had an email only yesterday from a young man who had just come back from travelling the world looking. He'd been to practically every major medical institution and non-medical institution in the world looking for a cure from his asthma. And he wrote to me, he said, "Since I've seen you and stayed with you, I've never had another asthmatic attack. This is what you can achieve if you want." And that's the answer to all of us. You don't have to be affected. You don't have to suffer from any of these conditions if you are willing to change your lifestyle. If you are willing to accept, and this is the hard one, that all disease, all acute disease, is in actual fact your body endeavouring to heal itself from what you have done or what I have done to myself. And once you understand that, and once you understand that chronic disease is the effect of us endeavouring to heal our acute disease, that you can overcome all your chronic diseases. It doesn't matter what they are. You can overcome all your acute diseases. It doesn't matter what they are. If you understand that they are working towards helping you get better. That is the healing process. It's a natural healing process. But it is your choice. I can't force you to do it. Nobody can force us to do it. We all have this choice. So I leave that with you today. You have a choice to either experience the measles and the mumps and the rubella or whatever else, you have a choice not to do so. But if you do so, then you know what is happening. You know that you have broken the laws of nature in some way, in the way that you are living. Usually, the main factor is the way you're eating. But there are other factors. I will say to you quite candidly, you can be doing everything that's right in your life. You can be exercising, you can be eating properly, you can be doing breathing properly and so on. But you can still kill yourself with your own thoughts. I've seen this happen. I'm not talking about theory. I'm talking about practice. So you have to get your head right. Don't forget that. So, but thank you for listening to me. Thank you for allowing me to be here.